Welcome back. Welcome back. Your man Dominic K in here, of course. The Dominic K Show on fire-tv.com. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for tuning in. Happy Monday to everybody. A lot of things going on. My goodness. Hope everybody had a great weekend and all of that. We have a lot of stories to get into today. A lot of topics I want to discuss. I want to talk about this Ebony K. Williams bus driver comments that have sparked some debate. I want to get into that. This SUV driver hit a crowd at a Texas bus stop near the border. Unfortunately, 8 dead. Driver in the Texas crash has been charged with manslaughter. 1 dead, 3 injured in a shooting near Frostburg State University. We're going to talk about that. Diddy reveals a date and a venue for the Jermaine Dupri versus battle, which I didn't think was going to happen, but it appears that it will. Tennessee team pepper sprayed a teacher after her cell phone was confiscated. We'll talk about that. And of course, 3 dead in a murder suicide outside Annapolis. This hotel, I mean, it is really A lot going on. And, we're going to mix it up. But the shootings that we are seeing at an all-time high. As I said, we're going to get into all of that right after this. Thank you for tuning in to On Fire TV. We are a 24-hour independent news and entertainment channel. We produce original movies, documentaries, reality-based shows, and podcasts. On Fire TV is made possible because of viewer and listener support. Go to onfire-tv.com to become an On Fire Plus member. Your dollars and your support have kept us going, and we are just getting started. So Ebony K. Williams is an attorney. She's a TV host. And she was speaking to Ayanla Van Zandt, and they were talking about masculine versus female energy. And this was an interview on The Grill, which is Byron Allen's network. So Ebony K. Williams sparked major controversy after commenting that she would only date a bus driver if he owns the bus. So, of course, folks feeling a lot of different ways about this. And she's an attorney. So she's tries to spin it and kind of move the goalpost at different points in times, and claims that the reasons like income and status, many women feel that the dating pool is unbalanced. She asks Van Zandt for advice for women who want to position themselves to be more feminine in romantic relationships. Her response to Ayanla's question, would you date a bus driver, just put social media into a frenzy. And it was an interesting conversation. That's a problem. The standards and the criteria that we use to measure men is off for who we are as women and who they are in society. I would date a bus driver, Ayanla Van Zandt said, who is 69 years old. I mean, she's a wise woman. And at its core, I agree with Ayanla Van Zandt 100%. 100%. When you talk about if Ayanla Van Zandt asked me that question, would I date a bus driver, right? Of course, I'm going to ask, well, what does she look like, right? Is she fine? Am I attracted to her? Because her job alone should not be a reason for me to date her or not date her. And I think that this thought process, you know, and I saw Ebony K. Williams on The Breakfast Club, and she was in major spin mode, trying to spin it, trying to say, oh, I'm trying to, you know, want a black people to be better and be excellent in a bus driver's a mediocre job. Shut up. This kind of thinking, getting in the minds of women, is a big problem, right? You date somebody because of your attraction to that person. If you vibe with that person, the job that they have at the moment, jobs come and go. You got people in you know, six-figure jobs who have gotten fired, who've lost that income, who've lost sponsors, whatever their job was, and they lost that, right? You can go up and you can come down. So where you are at the moment, whether it's perceived to be down or perceived to be up, that can change. You have to be connected, bonded, attracted to the person you're dating to have true longevity and true happiness. So that's a big problem. Ayanla said the standards and the criteria that we use, talking about women, to measure men is off. Ayanla said that. There's not enough discussion on that, and that is so true. She said, I'm not going to say this again. I love this statement. The standards and the criteria that we use to measure men is off for who we are as women and who they are in society. Ayanna said that she would date a bus driver. Ebony K. Williams said she would not. Now, here's the thing. She's entitled to her opinion. Of course, you date who you want to date. But let's look at the reasoning here, and let's not over index. Let's not over and take Ebony K. Williams' thoughts and apply it too broadly, right? Because she is single. She is not the authority on relationships. She's not married herself, right? Some people said that the statement was anti-black. Ebony K. recently released a book called Bet on Black, Good News About Being Black in America, and was the Real Housewives of New York first black cast member. Since this clip surfaced, Williams has been on several different platforms to defend and further explain her thoughts on the matter. She said that no matter your position or how this convo makes you feel, we have got to reckon with these issues within the black community now or deal with the consequences later, she wrote on Instagram. Here's my thing. If you say, I won't date this person because they're doing a mediocre job, right? In your opinion, mediocre, I think, is subjective. And then she tried to spin and talk about, oh, mediocre is not a bad thing. Somebody says that her sex game was mediocre. She would take that as an insult. If somebody said she's single because as a girlfriend, as a partner, she's mediocre, she would take that as an insult. But she tried to spin it. She tried to spin it. I think she did a poor job of spinning. Poor job of spinning. One thing, Ebony K. Williams has never been shy about giving her opinions, and I think that she's entitled to give her opinions, right? There was a time when she criticized Donald Trump when she was working as a host on Fox News. Yes, she worked at Fox News. No surprise there, right? That led to death threats among more than 100 messages from viewers who disliked her commentary, berating Trump for siding with violent white supremacists who rallied in Charlottesville back in 2017. You know, I think that a lot of women feel like Ebony K. Williams does. And her saying some of the things that she said gives some women justification to try to look down on guys that they think can't provide for them. She said that the man needed to own the bus company and not be the driver. I don't have a problem with that, right? I don't have a problem with that. Ebony K. Williams makes a certain amount of money. And in her mind, she may say that I don't like the optics of dating someone who's not an owner of the company, right? But I think that if you look at the individual person, he may work for he may drive a bus, but he may have a lot of different assets. And I'm sure that given a certain situation, she may say, okay, usually I don't do this, but I'm going to give this man a shot. That may happen, right? But women, don't get it twisted. Like, don't get confused because this successful woman is saying this and think that applies. You should use that logic yourself. I think that you should date, ladies, you should date someone who you're attracted to, who you can vibe with, who you can build with. And even if they are a bus driver, that should not exclude them from consideration if you are looking. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, TikTok, at the Dom and K Show, of course, on fire-tv.com, on fire-tv.com. Of course, you can visit the site, on fire-tv.com, hit the shop button, buy some merch, support this independent movement. We got a lot of shows, a lot of content, a lot of original programming in the works on deck. You can check me out weekdays right here at 6 p.m. anywhere you get your podcast, anywhere. Just search The Dom and K Show. We'll be back with more of the program after this.
Looking for food that feeds your soul? Hoodfellas Bistro and Catering is your local African-American-owned restaurant offering American cuisine. Located across from the courthouse, we offer daily jury specials to reward civic duty. Enjoy our full-service restaurant and fully stocked bar. Dine in, pick up, delivery, and catering. Our themed happy hours feature live music, handcrafted drinks, and weekly specials. Book your private event at hoodfellowsbistrocatering.com.
Visit onfiretv.com for live top stories, breaking news, and original shows. It's the Diamond K Show.
So much going on in the world. You talk about things from the perspective of how it is. DJ Diamond K, sometimes it comes off like you are almost not in support of, but you just accept the way things are and there's no chance of change. Check me out on YouTube. That's the part that I am just like, argh.
OnFireTV.com.
Welcome back. You made Diamond K in here. Of course, the Diamond K Show on fire-tv.com. On fire-tv.com. An SUV driver hits a crowd at a Texas bus stop near the border, leaving 8 dead. This death toll rose to 8. Man, it's just this vehicle slams into a crowd of folks on a bus stop outside of a migrant shelter in the border city of Brownville, Texas. At least 10 others were injured. And there's no bench at the unmarked city bus stop. Some of the victims were sitting on the curb around 8:30 a.m. when the driver hit them. Surveillance video from the Bishop Enrique San Pedro Center showed this. Brownsville police investigator who confirmed the latest death yesterday said that the police did not even know whether the collision was intentional. What are you talking about? The shelter director said that the SUV ran up on the curb, flipped, and continued moving for about 200 feet. Some people were walking on the sidewalk about 30 feet from the main group. They were even hit. Witnesses detained the driver as he tried to run away and held him until police arrived. The vehicle was a Range Rover, and it just ran the light about 100 feet away when people were sitting on the bus stop. It is a mess. Thankfully, there is surveillance video. Victims struck by the vehicle were waiting for the bus to return to downtown Brownsville after spending the night at an overnight shelter. Most of the victims were Venezuelan men. Brownsville has seen a surge of Venezuelan migrants over the last 2 years for unclear reasons. On Thursday, 4,000 of the 6,000 immigrants in the Border Patrol custody in Texas, Rio Grande Valley, were Venezuelan. The driver was taken to a hospital for injuries sustained when the vehicle flipped over. There were no passengers in the car. Police did not immediately know the driver's name or age yesterday. But, you know, it is a really crazy situation. Crazy situation. We've been talking about migrants. We've been talking about, you know, the expected surge. But the driver, thankfully, in this Texas crash has been charged with manslaughter. And, you know, authorities believe that the driver, so yesterday they didn't know his name. Today we learned that he is George Alvarez, 34 years old, of Brownsville. They're saying that he lost control after running the red light Sunday morning, plowed into the crowd. So was it intentional? Was it not? They are still investigating that. Ran the red light, lost control, flipped over on its side, striking, it appears to be, 18 people. Six dying at the scene, 12 people critically injured. Then the death toll later rising to 8. Let's understand this. He did try to flee. Thankfully, he was held down by people on the scene. Police retrieved a blood sample and sent it to the Texas Department of Public Safety. So they're going to test that for intoxicants. We're going to see about that. Yeah, I just, you know, sad story here. Folks already going through a lot and then facing this tragedy. Sad. This is the Dominic Hay Show, of course, on fire-tv.com. Take a quick break, and we'll be back with more of the show after this. So we've been talking about it, and you're going to hear me mentioning this more and more because we are going to be streaming from this event. But not only that, this is an indoor-outdoor pre-Memorial Day Adidas party. So break out those shoes, break out the outfits. It goes down at the Patapsco Arena Sunday, May the 28th from 8 p.m. to 2 a.m. Check this out. Two ballrooms, an outside tent. So this is outside, inside, indoor, outdoor. Check out this all-star DJ lineup. DJ Tons, DJ Kenny K, DJ Booby, DJ Scotty B, DJ One Love, DJ Gutta. Oh, I'm not finished yet. DJ Manny, DJ Kiwi, Mr. Incredible, DJ Double L, DJ Hot Toddy, all hosted by April Watts, Ryan DeLion, Big Status. There's free limited food, cash bar. Tickets are only $30. Tables are $300, and you can get those tickets right now. Now, check this out. You've got to have a ticket to get in this event. Let me say that again. This is a ticket-only event. So you got to get those tickets. DTLR, M&K Music Warehouse Security Mall, Silver Star Restaurant, 801 Bonaparte, their Cash App at Terry T Productions, Zelle 443-953-1966, Terry T Productions, 443-953-1966. This is a ticket-only event. No ticket, no entry, no exceptions. The indoor-outdoor pre-Memorial Day Adidas party at Patapsco Arena Sunday, May the 28th from 8 p.m. to 2 a.m. Now, check this out. This is for grown folks. I understand some of our young listeners – and some of our, you know, young viewers, this is not the party for you. This is a grown folks party brought to you by Terry T and Sean Marshall, the pre-Memorial Day Adidas party. We're going to be streaming live from this event, streaming live at onfire-tv.com. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to it. Get those tickets right now. Welcome back. Welcome back. Your man Diamond K in here. Of course, the Diamond K Show on fire-tv.com. Just a crazy weekend. A man fatally shot two other people before turning the gun on himself Friday outside of an Annapolis hotel that is here in Maryland. Annapolis is I guess, 40 minutes from Baltimore. And, you know, it's the capital of Maryland. Anne Arundel Police, Jacqueline Davis, who is a lieutenant, said that officers were called shortly before 2 p.m. on Friday to a Holiday Inn Express hotel in Annapolis for a shooting. Police said that a man shot another man and a woman and then turned the gun on himself in the hotel parking lot. The gunman and the woman who died on the scene, the man who was shot, left the scene in a car, went to a store, was taken to a hospital where he later died. Senseless. Three individuals lost to gun violence in our country, just adding to the hundreds and thousands of folks that have passed in this way. If you see signs of your loved ones in distress, despondent, or indicating their intent to harm someone, please call to try to get them help. For far too long, people have ignored these warning signs. And then we get this. It is unknown whether the involved were related. Definitely my hearts go out to the families. Obviously, they're going to be processing this grief, processing this trauma. It is a devastating loss to the community. There's a lot to unpack. A lot to unpack. I'm just sorry for everybody that is involved. As I said, three dead in a shooting at a hotel in Annapolis, Maryland. Police say that a man shot a woman and another man and then himself, female victim, and the suspect died at the scene. The male drove himself to a nearby store, but later died. I mean, this is just repeating over and over and over and over again. What can we do?
You're watching OnFire-TV.com, featuring news, interviews, and entertainment. Broadcasting from Radio On Fire Studios in Baltimore, Maryland, here's your host, Diamond K.
Welcome back. Welcome back. Your man Diamond K in here. Of course, the Diamond K Show. If you need to get in touch with me, very easy to do that. DJ Diamond K at gmail.com. DJ Diamond K at gmail.com. So we've just been sharing what I call bad stories, terrible stories, and sadly is more of the same. Feds are looking into whether the gunman who killed eight people at a Dallas area mall expressed interest in white supremacy Sunday as they work to discern a motive for that attack. A Dallas law enforcement official told the Associated Press that the official cautioned that the investigation is in its early stages, so they don't have, obviously, all of the information. They don't have everything that they need to know just yet. But details are unfolding. So feds have been reviewing social media accounts that they believe were used by Garcia, 33 years old. The post that expressed interest in white supremacy and neo-Nazi views. Could not discuss all the details. As I said, it is still early in the investigation. But in addition to reviewing these social media posts, the feds have interviewed family members, associates of Garcia to ask about his beliefs. The officials said the investigators are reviewing financial records and online posts. And as you can see, this is how they investigate this. Garcia was fatally shot Saturday by a police officer who happened to be near the suburban Dallas Mall. A law enforcement official said investigators have been searching a Dallas motel near the interstate where Garcia had been staying. The officials said the police found multiple weapons at the scene after Garcia was killed, including an AR-15-styled rifle and a handgun. A woman who lives three houses from the low brick house said that she saw a large group of uniformed officers go into a home Saturday between 6 and 7 p.m. Sunday, a lady was sitting on a porch of her house next door, and they noticed that they searched that residence. But even the president has given a statement saying that the assailant wore tactical gear and fired an AR-15 style weapon. And he again urged Congress to act on just some tighter restrictions on firearms and ammunition. The shooting is the latest attack contributed to the unprecedented mass shootings. This pace is staggering. Barely a week before, five people were fatally shot in Cleveland, Texas, when a neighbor asked a man to stop firing his weapon while a baby slept. This year, we've seen an average of about one mass killing per week. The wounded have remained in the hospital as of yesterday, three in critical condition and four in fair condition. We are praying for those affected by this. This attack unfolded at Allen Premium Outlets, a sprawling outdoor shopping center. Witnesses reported seeing children among the victims. Some say that they saw what appeared to be a police officer and a mall security guard unconscious on the ground. Allen is about 25 miles north of downtown Dallas, with a population of about 105,000 residents, and it is among the Dallas-Fort Worth area diverse suburbs. The area saw the largest Asian American growth rate of any U.S. major metro area, according to census figures. Those statistics show that Allen's population is about 19% Asian, 10% Black, 11% Hispanic. So, it is going. As the world turns, so turns the world. Welcome back. You made Dominic K in here, of course, the Dominic K Show on fire-tv.com, on fire-tv.com. So this video that was circulating shows a Tennessee teen pepper spraying a teacher. And, what did this teacher do to warrant this pepper spray? All right. The teacher confiscated the phone, but this high school teacher pepper sprayed twice by an unruly student who became incensed. She was just outraged after he confiscated her phone during class. So this dramatic cell phone footage taken Friday at Antioch High School captures this rambunctious student confronting her teacher after her phone was taken away as a disciplinary action. The disobedient student had been texting and Googling answers for her schoolwork. In the minute-long video, a female student can be seen getting up from her desk and walking out of the classroom as the student, another student, is filming, repeated, exclaims, "Nah, Mace is crazy." Students in the classroom laugh and joke before following the rebellious student into the hallway, where she can be seen trying to get her phone back from the teacher. By the time the student filming enters the hallway, the teacher can be heard telling someone in a different classroom, "She just pepper sprayed me." The female student follows him out of the classroom, telling him, "Give me my phone." She then holds the pepper spray close to his face before spraying him a second time, causing him to fall on his knees and yell. Another adult emerges from the neighboring classroom to intervene as the female student continues demanding the teacher give her back her phone. "She pepper sprayed me," the teacher says, after standing up, to which students reply, "Okay, now give me my phone." The student holds steady in her demands, even as another teacher steps in to tell her, "No, not now." The video ends with the pepper spray teacher coughing. According to the poster of the video, this was the second time this teacher has been assaulted by a student. 2 months earlier, the same teacher was punched in the face after taking a different student's phone, and they were caught cheating on a test. You know, a lot of users have been quick to come to the defense of the teacher and condemn the student's behavior. A lot of people calling for her expulsion and arrest. But some people are coming to the defense of the student. Some people have been coming to the defense of the student, talking about they took her phone, that was larceny, all this kind of stuff. I do not feel that students should have cell phones in classes. Now, I know some people are going to say, "Oh my God, what if it's an emergency? I bought that cell phone for my students." Okay, there weren't always cell phones in classrooms. If you have an emergency, you call the school. You call the office. How are you going to call the student? They're in class. They're supposed to be learning. The cell phone is a leisure item, not for class. Not for class. Parents say, I bought the cell phone and my student should be able to have it. My child should be able to have it. And this is the mindset of kids bringing the guns. "I bought the gun." They bring a gun to school. You bring the cell phone to school. Everything that you buy is not for school. When you go to certain events, comedy shows and such, they take your cell phone. Students should not be allowed to have cell phones in school. I don't care who bought it. There are rules and regulations. We are raising a generation of heathens and just mindless kids. We're going to become mindless adults. So I don't think that a cell phone should be in school. It's distracting the kids. It's distracting them. They should be locked in a locker. It shouldn't even be allowed in school. There are some items that should not be allowed in school. I don't care that the parent bought them. Maybe if you want your student to have their cell phone, then why don't you teach your kids? But there should be rules. There should be rules. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, TikTok, at the Dom and K Show. Of course, on fire-tv.com. So I talked about this last week, and I said I didn't think it was going to happen. Diddy has revealed that he and Jermaine Dupri have set a date and a venue for a versus battle. I'm looking forward to this. I might need to be in the building. Of course, we previously talked about Jermaine Dupri revealing that he has unreleased music from the Notorious Big and Jay-Z. He noted that he would drop the unreleased music against Diddy if they ever did a versus battle, which I think he should have kept under wraps, because I don't know if that's even a good thing. According to Diddy, a date and venue have been set for a face-off between these legendary producers. While backstage at a show, Diddy, Fabolous, and Busta Rhymes could be seen talking to one another while hyping Diddy up before he hit the stage. Busta was talking to Diddy about a song before Puff interjected and said, September 8th at the Garden, me and Jermaine Dupri. This excited Fab and Busta even more, giving Diddy more support before he hit the stage. Man. Diddy said to Busta, we're going to have you out the rafters, flying out the sky. Jermaine Dupri, Timbaland, or Swiss Beatz have not confirmed this yet. But Diddy saying it, that sounds like that's going to happen. That's big. That's big. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Of course, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, TikTok, at the Diamond K Show. Of course, on fire-tv.com. Who wins this battle? Jermaine Dupri, Diddy. Two of the biggest to ever do it in the game. Looking forward to that as always. Thank you for tuning in to On Fire TV. We are a 24-hour independent news and entertainment channel. We produce original movies, documentaries, reality-based shows, and podcasts. On Fire TV is made possible because of viewer and listener support. Go to onfire-tv.com to become an On Fire Plus member. Your dollars and your support have kept us going, and we are just getting started. Of course, I will be back here tomorrow, 6 p.m. for the Diamond K Show. Anywhere you get your podcast, just search the Diamond K Show. You need to get in touch with me for any business or any other info. DJDiamondK@gmail.com. DJDiamondK@gmail.com. Of course, on all social media, I am at the Diamond K Show. And, I'm excited for the upcoming summer. We have so many things on deck. And so many events where we'll come out to your events. We'll promote your items. You can do an advertising package here at On Fire TV. You can sponsor any of our shows, the Diamond K Show and others. And we're going to be at the pre-Memorial Day Adidas party that's going down here in Baltimore. A little bit more on that. So we've been talking about it, and you're going to hear me mentioning this more and more because we are going to be streaming from this event. But not only that, this is an indoor-outdoor pre-Memorial Day Adidas party. So break out those shoes, break out the outfits. It goes down at the Patapsco Arena Sunday, May the 28th from 8 p.m. to 2 a.m. Check this out. Two ballrooms. An outside tent. So this is outside, inside, indoor, outdoor. Check out this all-star DJ lineup. DJ Tons, DJ Kenny K, DJ Booby, DJ Scotty B, DJ One Love, DJ Gutta. Oh, I'm not finished yet. DJ Manny, DJ Kiwi, Mr. Incredible, DJ Double L, DJ Hot Toddy, all hosted by April Watts, Ryan DeLion, Big Status. There's free limited food, cash bar. Tickets are only $30. Tables are $300, and you can get those tickets right now. Now, check this out. You've got to have a ticket to get in this event. Let me say that again. This is a ticket-only event, so you got to get those tickets. DTLR, M&K Music Warehouse Security Mall, Silver Star Restaurant, 801 Bonaparte, their Cash App at Terry T Productions, Zelle 443-953-1966, Terry T Productions, 443-953-1966. This is a ticket-only event, no ticket, no entry, no exceptions. The indoor-outdoor pre-Memorial Day Adidas party at Patapsco Arena, Sunday, May the 28th from 8 p.m. to 2 a.m. Now, check this out. This is for grown folks. I understand some of our young listeners and some of our young viewers. This is not the party for you. This is a grown folks party brought to you by Terry T and Sean Marshall, the pre-Memorial Day Adidas party. We're going to be streaming live from this event. streaming live at onfire-tv.com. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to it. Get those tickets right now.